chose the topic because it's a little unusual if you're going to my class, I would talk about the fundamentals of the faith, about basic belief and core belief and so on. So I thought something different. But the reason in this house, a year or 2 years ago, I gave some talk on the relationship between religion and politics. If you remember, I talked about the fact that we take for granted today, we look at the map, religious map of the globe, we say, oh, you can find it. How the earth is pulled up, you know, the all areas predominantly Christian, the areas predominantly Islamic, the areas predominantly Hindu, Buddhist, and so on. And I tried to explain that historically it is very easy to understand the map. Because there is a very strong connection between the rulers and the religion that they have and the public. I say, if you look at Christianity today, well, obviously we focus on the Roman Empire, which is Europe. North Africa, because it just happened that when Christ was born, he was born within that empire, a very remote corner of the Roman Empire. But nonetheless, the Roman, just a generation before Christ, had incorporated Judea to this vast empire which covered all of North Africa and much of Europe. So in this sense, Christ is a part of that Roman Empire. And a religion is started to spread from there, mostly within the Roman Empire. But what really happened, which changed the course of history of Europe and this of the world, was that in 313 AD, 300 years after Christ, a Roman emperor embraced Christianity. So Constantine became a Christian. And then when again look at the map of what follows Christianization of the emperor, then you follow the Christianization of the empire. Notice, you know, the legend that he had this vision, Constantine 313, looking at the cross and so on. 313. But 400, the whole Roman Empire had become Christian. Few years later, if you were not a Christian, you could not be a citizen of Rome. It is how fast the change in politics and religion. Again, historians can go on and on explaining what is the reason why this world, which was so diverse at the time of Constantine. Again, historians believe that the number of Christians within the Roman Empire varies anywhere between 5% and 1/20. In other words, Christians were far from being the majority. But within a generation, it changed. I thought the majority, as I said, by 400, if you were not a Christian, you would not be a citizen of Rome. So this is how we start, found the base, and then we look at the map of the globe today. So it was really the extension of Europe the discovery of the New World, how it continues gained. The conquest of South Africa, South America by the Spaniards. So how Christianity came to the New World, because in this it was the extension of European. The same thing also very dramatically is about Islam. Then you look at the map of the world, roughly around the time of 700 AD, Muhammad died in the year 632 AD. His followers, again, we are not going to get involved for the reason, but the fact is, when Muhammad died, his religion, Islam, was very much confined to Arabia, not outside of Arabia. But then, not for religious reasons, for all other reasons except religion, the Arabs left Arabia, and they conquered whatever they could find, especially to the north and to the east. And so all of a sudden, 100 years exactly after the death of Muhammad, as I said, this was 632 AD, for 732 AD, literally the Arabs established an empire from the heart of India to the heart of Europe that had gone through Spain, that go through Pyrenees into France. Again, that's interesting, they exactly one of the most decisive battles in this Western civilization, the Battle of Tours, 732, exactly. 100 years after the death of Muhammad, his followers were stopped just out in the past. This was the extent of the Islamic Empire. Again, it was not that the Arabs left Arabia in order to convert everybody to their religion. That was far from their purpose. Make the people go create an empire for much more selfish reasons, immediately. But the fact is, and they in 72 never tried to force those whom they conquered to embrace Islam. Particularly they were Christian. Again, if you look at the map, north of Africa, of course, was Christian before Arabs came in. Spain, much of France. But the fact is that many embraced Islam about 732. This Arab empire became also Islamic empire. People, for whatever reason, embraced the religion of the Lord. So that has been the case. And I can make the same argument for how in India or in China of this religion. A good example, again, is in Russia, around, well, the Tsars, when you look again at the map of Christianity in Europe, until about 700-800 years after Christ, still had not penetrated Russia. But the Tsar of Russia became a Christian, and we had all of the subjects baptized in the river.